One of these things is not like the other. One of these things just doesn't belong. Well, I ate them all in my salad for lunch, so I'm not really sure which one of these is the odd one out. What do you think, scientist? Which one of these might be different? I'll give you a hint. One of these salad ingredients is not a plant, and the rest of them are. But what is a plant? Are you ready to dig in and find out? Let's go! We already know that plants are living things. But what makes something a plant and not some other type of living thing, like a person or an animal? Well, first of all, plants have special parts to their bodies that humans and animals don't have. And each of their parts does something special to help the plant stay alive. Let's take a closer look. Here's a tomato plant. Check out the long, thin pieces down here. These are called roots, and most of the time, plants keep their roots under the soil. The roots help the plant stay in one place in the ground, which is really different from how humans and animals work. That's not all roots do. They have the super important job of absorbing water, soaking up the moisture and nutrients from the soil to give the plants a drink. Where does all that water go? Well, it has to travel up this long road called the stem. The stem is what holds the whole plant together. Since the stem is connected to every part of the plant, it is the part that delivers the water and nutrients wherever they need to go. Plants don't have mouths, so they can't eat food the same way we do. Instead, the leaves work to turn sunlight into food. Do you remember the specific, special, scientific name for that? Photosynthesis! Yeah! Leaves are another important part of plants because they use photosynthesis to make sure the plant has enough energy to grow. There's one more part of the plant we have to talk about. This part helps the plant make more of itself. What's that called again? Oh yeah, reproduction. The plant parts that help with reproduction are the flower and the fruit. Not all plants you see will have these parts, but most of them do. That's because they help produce the seeds that will create more plants. Since most plants start out with a seed, that's another thing that makes plants so special. They have a special life cycle. That means they grow according to certain stages or steps. The first step is a seed. When the seed gets soil, sunlight, and water, that's when it is able to move on to the next stage of the life cycle, germination. When something is germinating, the plant is starting to sprout out of the seed for the first time. Usually a plant will start by growing a tiny root and tiny stem, and the stem will pop out of the soil. That's germination. How do you know when a plant is done germinating and is moving on to the next stage in its life cycle? When the first leaf forms on the top of the stem, the plant is officially done germinating and is starting its next stage of life as a seedling. A seedling is any plant that's still growing or maturing and doesn't have its fruit or flowers yet. When the plant is producing flowers, it's no longer a seedling. This stage of a plant's life cycle is called the adult plant. This stage means that the plant has matured and is ready to reproduce to make more plants. An adult plant makes new seeds that can germinate and grow. And the cycle starts over again and again. Thanks to plants, we have delicious fruits to eat. But fruit isn't the only amazing thing that plants give us. They also grow a lot of different items that we make food out of. A peanut plant provides us with its seeds that we use to make peanut butter. And a cacao tree gives us the seeds that are used to create chocolate. The gooey sap inside a maple tree is used to make maple syrup. Now I'm hungry. Maybe I should go make another salad. Plants also keep us safe by providing shelter. We use the wood from trees to help us make our homes. Other animals might use pieces of plants or even the plants themselves as shelter. We can even create useful items from plant parts. The pencil you use to take your notes is made with the wood from a tree, and so is the paper that you write things on. Lots of clothes are made out of cotton, which comes from a cotton plant. Probably the most important thing that plants make for us is oxygen. Oxygen is that special part in the air that keeps us alive, and plants are the ones that make it. So, really, we wouldn't be able to live without plants. Now we know that plants are made up of special plant parts. They have a life cycle and they give us tons of important things, like the oxygen we breathe and the delicious salad I had for lunch. Remember, one of these ingredients is not a plant. And now that we know what plants are, I bet we can figure it out. Go ahead and pause the video here and predict which one of these four foods is not considered part of a plant. Let's see. Tomatoes and cucumbers are parts of plants. The part that we eat is the fruit. Here they are growing on a plant alongside its roots, stems, leaves, and flowers. We don't eat the fruit of spinach, we eat the leaves. But just like tomatoes and cucumbers, spinach has roots, stems, leaves, and even flowers and fruits. If you're thinking, that sounds an awful lot like a plant, that's because spinach is a plant. Mushrooms, on the other hand, don't have roots, flowers, or leaves. Without leaves, they cannot use photosynthesis to make their own food. Without flowers, they can't have seeds, so they reproduce with something called spores. A mushroom doesn't have the plant parts that we might expect, and that's because it's not a plant. Mushrooms are actually something called fungi, but just because they aren't a plant doesn't make them any less delicious. We already knew that living things were all around us, but now we know that plants are specific types of living things that have their own special plant parts, go through a life cycle, and help us out in more ways than we can count. Without plants, life sure wouldn't be the same. So what are you waiting for, scientists? Go ask your grown-up when you can get out into nature and observe some plants. You're bound to learn a lot of cool and interesting things, because remember, science is all around you.